Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 217 of Don't Starve, Reign of Giants. Last episode, just watch as I rotate the camera and their eyes all change. Three houndiashootiuses! Oh my god. So we got three houndiashootiuses plopped down. We started putting tooth traps down just to guard them. Pushed a handful of spiders back because, well, they pose a threat to this. Because they could just simply overwhelm it. Naturally, they break walls as they push towards them, so I don't want anything to do with that at all. That's why I got rid of them. And I am just making tooth traps. I also need to make more rope, but that's why we bought grass. We're gonna, like, plop tooth traps all around this just to guard it. I mean, similar to what we have up north, I guess northwest here. You circle whatever's important in the middle, you guard it with tooth traps. That's the goal. I mean, you'd like to kill the majority of enemies. And of course, I have to... I think if an enemy is aggroed to me, that they shoot at it. Otherwise, if I go to attack something, then they do. So, like, if I go to attack a spider, then they'll go to attack the spider. I'm not sure if they attack things that are aggroed on me, so I'm not sure if they'll attack the hounds by themselves. I think they will, but I'm not 100%. It doesn't take away from the fact that we are three hounded shooties and it's so cool looking. That's awesome. So we're just going to hug this campfire basically all night. Just keep using it to stay warm as we build, well, all night and all day. Use it as we build here. Stupid snow is going to put a, I was going to say rain on my parade, but I guess it's really not rain now, is it? Metaphorically rain on my parade. Hound's teeth are my limiting factor here, but there's a freaking scaled chest full of them at home. I can go get a couple more of them, no issue there. Manager took care of the log supply. In fact, I bet the biggest drawback or biggest issue I have right now is the grass. Yes, I have like three chests full of grass, but it's also rope, so it's 3-to-1 rope, and then you need rope. Yeah, it's just, it's messy. Very messy, just the sheer amount of things we require. I can take this stack of 40. Mind you. And we can, okay. I don't know if that did anything at all. Yeah, it did, because we got rid of a tooth trap that I wasn't saying the tooth trap in the first inventory slot. That lets me carry an extra one. And of course I can craft them over here. Well, if I had house teeth, I could. Let's pick the ones up that we have crafted and go get some more, I guess, rope. Oh god, get more rope and hound's teeth. Don't really need logs, but I guess I should top off the stack we have. That's not a bad idea. Just plop these all around, man. It's obviously not as dense. It's also a larger area to guard. It's not as dense as the previous tooth trap farm or kill box we had up north. Because, well, I don't have the main tooth traps just yet. Those were specifically designed to just kill anything that walks through there. And we've worked on that for a long time. Stop raining! What is it with the past few episodes in rain? What is going on? It is raining again. It rained for what, like 2 or 3 days last episode? At the last couple days of autumn? And now it's winter. It should be snowing. This is like a warning that we're going into adventure mode and I'm going to get rained on. And it's going to be terrible, isn't it? This is what they're telling me. This is exactly what it's telling me. Mean old game. I wonder how the season clock is going to handle... That's an interesting question. I wonder how the season clock's going to handle adventure mode. Because the seasons aren't normal in adventure mode. A lot of them are altered in some respect. I hope it doesn't like crash the game or something silly. I didn't even think about that until just now. Also, why is my thermal stone in my backpack? I don't really think it works to full effect if it is there. But, I mean, I'm picking up grass here. Of course, we could just go pull it out of the chest and use it. But, I mean, I've got my limitless supply here as long as I have rot. Which rot is limitless because spiders and other things. Light bulbs. Monster meat is probably one of my bigger supplies. And that and light bulbs, I mean. Rot's super easy to get. And, of course, there is the good old dookie. Beefalo buddies. So let's top the stack of logs off. Let's then top, give myself a stack of hound's teeth. And then right now, let's take all the grass that we just picked up, convert the vast majority of that into ropes, and we'll make another big old batch of tooth traps. This is sick. I like it. Why is this stuff not dried yet? I would really like to dry that and put some monster meat on the racks. Thermalstone's cold. I expect to start freezing here in a second. Come on, make more ropes, Weber. You should be like a professional rope weaver at this point in your life. You are the badass. You're the badass rope maker. I wonder how many ropes I've made in the course of this series. That's an interesting question. That is a good one indeed. So we'll do 20. That's another stack. We'll combine these two. And yeah, stuff's not done yet. Let's go ahead and get a fire going. Blazing, so I can get warm. Just make sure the fire is huge, like he said. Let the thermal stone stay close by. And numb on this because it's starting to go bad. And then eat monster meat. Of course, I could have them cannibalize again. But I think I have a okay supply as is. Yeah, for the moment we're fine. A stack of logs is what we needed. Okay, just to top off a stack. And hound's teeth. That's not the hound's teeth chest. This is the hound's teeth chest. extra silk, we can get rid of you. No extra glands. Okay, so toasty ass thermal stone. Oh my god, this thermal stone is so warm. Let's go. Oh, another one dried. Oh, I think they all just started drying. So we'll have some jerky when we go back. But right now, let's get this going. I can put the grass suits in here. I mean, they were specifically designed as cheap Krampus armor, you know, as we farmed him. So we can use that. I mean, of course, I have plenty of other things to use as fuel. And I believe this stuff, I don't know if I planted all of these. I'm not sure if I planted all of these or if they started spawning as it rained and flowers spread during spring. I'm not 100% on that one. Either way, we're here to make tooth traps. Lots and lots of tooth traps. And as you can see from in my inventory, I can easily make 40 with what we've got on us right now. Awesome. Let's go ahead and again, just I want to encircle this with tooth traps. That's the goal. Not sure how dense I'm going to make it, because realistically, we're not going to see too much use out of this, sadly. I mean, that sucks, but I mean, because we're going into adventure mode here shortly. But yeah, that sucks, because this is the sad part is, like I was talking about earlier, the balance for these things. They're super late game, and they're not exactly strong by any means, and you don't really get to use them that much when you actually have them. I mean, how much longer are you, what else are you going to do after you've explored every set of ruins? I've done quite a bit in this game. Petals, let me utilize you as a fuel source, which, yes, it's cold, but it'll let me see here. I could use the grass suit, but that should be enough to let me see and work. The whole point of that was I don't have to use the torch to place tooth traps. I bet the flowers are going to get in my way. Weber's breath is cold, so I'm probably going to start chilling soon. I mean, we are next to an endothermic fire. Let's stand over here. Grass, turf, one here. We have a couple more. I think we have two stacks in that chest left. There we go. Let's pick up what we have on the ground. Yum, yum, gimme, gimme. And continue placement. This is amazing. It's so sad it's not going to get used as much as I want, but still, it's huge. This is hilarious. No, don't pick that one up. Also, let's swap that around. My food doesn't go on the far left. That's never been where I place my food. Usually a hat or something as Weber. Yeah, it looks like we have to pick some of the stuff up. Let's pick up these flowers. Of course, these flowers were here so we could kill butterflies as we farmed Krampus. I mean, that's the original reason why they're here. Might as well keep you ablaze. And I have an extra tooth trap I can craft, and we'll free up a couple inventory slots when we craft our next tooth trap. Nice. Because we were one log and we were one rope. There we are. And it looks like we're almost all the way circled around, and now we'll be filling in the gaps, pretty much. Making them more dense. I like it. I have to move a lot of these items, in fact. I mean, remember, we made all of these spears and stuff. This was stuff that was being used to kill Krampus repeatedly, because I didn't want to keep wasting tentacle spikes, because they're not exactly as easy to obtain as, say, a regular spear. And of course, the amount of logs we required for log suits drove me to use grass suits instead. Yeah, this is where it all began, guys. That was so many episodes of Krampus farming. Good stuff. So glad we got the Krampus sack, though. It's so good. It's so useful. So we have looped around, more or less. I mean, here could use some more. Let's pull these out, just so I have some room to place some things. Here you are, Mr. Football Helmet. We were using that as well with the grass suit. Combined damage reduction. Worked out rather well. And more tooth traps. The theme of this episode, tooth traps, tooth traps, tooth traps. So let's add a few to this. Now, let's go around. Where's like the weakest spot? I mean, here could probably use another one. I would say here. Let's pick that up. Here. No, what do you mean you can't do that? There's like nothing there. Tooth trap placement's so wonky sometimes. This is looking okay. Craft a few more. Now, I mean, the problem is they don't always hit the tooth traps. This is why I made it super dense up north. Decrease the odds. So they could just run through here and they could go for the walls, but the tooth traps are very likely going to soften. Whatever it is comes over here up. And if I were to use this as like my hound killing box area machine thing, whatever we're calling it, it would require a lot of rocks because I would more than likely have to constantly repair things because they would get through and hit the walls. So basically it's super useless, but it's super freaking cool. What is in this backpack, out of curiosity? Ah, the boomerangs. I remember you. That Krampus sack. Look at the backpack's inventory space. Krampus sack. Oh yeah, I think we know what's better. Abso-freaking-lutely. So I can make, what, four more? I can make four more, and then we are out of tooth traps officially. Unless I wanted to go make more, but, I mean, I think we've got this place guarded. The vast majority of enemies, I mean, if I'm standing here, they could. They will likely spawn over here, not as much, but I bet they would come from over here on the right. Because, I mean, you know, if I stand here, they can't really spawn. This is a peninsula. It just kind of juts out. Like, if I stood here, they'd all be forced to spawn in this area. I wonder if they could spawn in the middle. I bet any money they could. That would be the end of it all. Spawns right next to the Houndy Shootius. Rip Houndy Shoot. Oh, man. I'm so sad even thinking about stuff like that. Stop it, game. Stop giving me these bad ideas. So, let's add to you, and I'm going to take a stack of 10 out of there. Let's leave the hammer behind. Got food, and it doesn't make sense to not cook this up. Actually, you know, it does. Yes, it does, because the stuff dried over here, right? This should be drying, or dried, and will turn into monster jerky. Yes, sir. We'll be getting a lot of monster jerky here. Give me that monster jerky. That way it lasts a little bit longer, and of course I can get some better use out of things. Now, it's basically adventure mode time. I'm scared. I'm so scared. Oh, you have no idea how worked up I get. This, you have. I honestly don't think people understand how stressful Don't Starve is to me, because I always strive to do good, and it is very mentally draining. I love playing the game, don't get me wrong, but doing it very well, it's super mentally draining. Requires a lot of focus, a lot of thought. I know that probably seems silly to most. Might as well eat the honey, just it's long gone, and I can eat some of the monster meat. Now I can bring the jerky because it'll keep for a while. Let us warm up our thermal stone, and I had an idea. Now the problem is it's winter, because what we'll be doing is we'll be going up here and we'll be at the door. There's a walrus camp right next to there. Yes, there's spiders there to protect me, but every time we come out and go in, we have to deal with the Mactusk and such. Spiders should deal with the threat, but I do want to put a campfire over there in case, you know, I die, I'm cold because it's winter when we come back. Might as well have a fire pit at the ready. So let's pull out 12 rocks. And of course we have one pre-crafted, but I want the extra one. And then, you know, as good as grass turf is, we can bring this and this will last us much longer. Because one is a fire for an extremely long period of time. An extremely long period of time, might I add. I love Glomber Gloop. Let's go check Glomber Gloop over here. See how that's doing. There's probably one or two, if I were to guess. I don't want to push him into the ocean. He's getting close. Yeah, let's bring him back. Yeah, there's two. You can get out of here, snowbird. Is it? It's a snowbird, right? Snowbird. Yes, excuse me, Azure Feathers. You are the crow. Yes, I got this. I can remember things. So, I think I will wait until daylight, because again, we'll be dealing with the Mactusk threat. Spiders should have taken care of that, but you never know. In fact, since I think about it, what we'll be doing is not spending much time here. So if I feed these guys, I keep them as allies. If I die and come back, and there's a Mactusk or something there, these spiders should still be with me. Bring them. Might want to get a couple more things of meat out of the icebox, in fact. I mean, just turn these. I mean, yeah, I have a couple, but the more the freaking merrier, right? So, if we started running up there now, we could probably get there before day hit. I put away the miner hat, didn't I? Oh, no, I didn't. I put it over here for some reason. Muggles, we don't really require these to be present. So the unofficial hat chest will leave you in there. I find that acceptable. Let's make another emergency torch. And I don't look forward to this, but I'm telling you now, this ain't gonna go well. I haven't started over in a very long time. I've become very complacent in my playstyle. Playing Weber instills bad character habits because you get used to you get reliant on the spiders. You get very reliant on them, and I can tell you this right now. As much as I know about the base game, I am very reliant on Weber at the moment and his spider bros. let's go up here. Let's go. And, you know, I'll pick up a couple logs up here, I guess. You can always use that as fuel, too. My thermal stone is still holding out. Torch is about to go, but I've got two emergency ones. And I will make another one because this one will probably die off. So I can't see for squat. Here's the logs we're finding. I wonder why these are going to be scattered throughout. Where did these logs come from, you might wonder? Berger! Destroy this place! Holy hell. Wait till we find where he's like ground pounding. Yeah, I mean, like broke rocks. He mined for me. This'll be fuel for the campfire. Yes, sir. Might as well fill up my pinecone stack. I mean, logs. I like it. Logs. Oh, no, it's extra pine cone. As much as I enjoy an extra pine cone, but you can do that. We've been over this. Don't let your dreams be dreams, Weber. I'm basically just waiting for it to be day before I go up there. I don't want to get shot off screen by his blow dart if he's alive, because that will hurt. There will be blue hounds. There will be the wee tusk. So there's going to be a couple things that are threatening. And here it goes. It should be day any second. Like I said, this torch will go out, and I can put the Lazy Explorer on. We'll be going back to being slow. Oh, hello. Okay, so it looks like they've already killed some of them. They killed the blue hounds. They're killing the pigs. Oh my god. That's right, when he ground pounded here. I know this is a bad idea, but... Oh, hello. You can come after me all you want, sir. Taste spiders. I want to get rid of those things because they'll take away sanity if I come back. Just kill it now. I'll pick up some regular flowers or something. There's a blow dart, so I guess they killed him, right? Oh, it was that dude. Oh, they didn't kill him yet. Ooh, you attacked the spider. That's a bad idea. And they should head him off. Any Tam O'Shanter drop? I mean, there's the meat, but... Oh, there's another Tam O'Shanter. If only I could bring this with me! Why can't I bring this with me? Damn it. Alright, Tam O'Shanter, I will leave you here. Spiders, I'll ally with you. This, I can drop. Campfire to keep us all toasty. There's a spot right there. Got it. Close. Use the extra logs we've got. They are clearly aplenty. They're every single spot we look. And of course, you don't take any items through this place. You don't get to bring anything with you. And if you die, you don't really get penalized. You just have to do it all over again. And obviously, as much as I enjoy it, I'd like to run through and not waste everybody's time. Cook this up, consume it, drop the silk. Basically getting some crap out of my inventory before I go. Because if I come back and I have to deal with something, I need to be prepared. Like, what if I come back to a deer collapse or a hound attack or something? So... Farewell, cruel world. We'll likely see you within the next 2 minutes when I die, but it is adventure mode time.
Deep breath.
So, we've seen this before in the vanilla series. Doorway to adventure. You're about to step into a long, arduous journey to find Maxwell. You will need to survive 5 worlds, each randomly generated to present a new challenge. Should you die, you'll be back at this portal. You will start back at this portal, but you will lose all your progress on the journey. So again, if you're not aware, you didn't watch the original series, maybe you've never seen adventure mode. This is a new world, generates a couple worlds. You have to survive like trials, there's challenges, there's lack of resources. It's really annoying. It's very difficult. And if you die, you lose those worlds, you lose your progress, but you come back to your main sandbox world. You don't lose this world. There's really no penalty. It's just you have to do it over again. So 200 episodes, 217, and we're going into adventure. Oh my god. I know 19 of them was when Reign of Giants was early access when we were Wilson, but still. Oh. I don't look forward to waking up and seeing Maxwell right here. King of Winter, no! I would rather just die and have to start over. This is terrible. This is an awful start. So we have to go through. If you could actually go away, that would be better. There should be a chest, right? So there's a backpack. So what happens is just an overview of King of Winter, where I'm probably going to die because it's a terrible, terrible thing to start off on. There are little gates you have to go through that have a requirement of you being insane if you're below 30 sanity, and then they lower the obelisks, and then you go through, and then once your sanity goes back up, they close, and there's like multiple sections of this world that are blocked by that. So you have to constantly lose and regain sanity. It's very difficult. This world is an infinite, it's in an infinite state. Oh god. It's in an infinite state of winter. Not cool. Rabbit earmuffs. If I prototype that, I would get sanity, right? So this is a warm thermal stone, because it just, everything burnt. Best thing I can think of right now would be to get a torch going, and then, it's a flint. But get a torch going and then start burning things to stay warm. So let's make an axe to get some logs. You basically can't piss any time around. You have to move in early King of Winter. I've never started off in it. I've had resources before I started it, and we're already cold. We don't have any warmth. So there's bunnies. We could go capture bunnies. Resources don't grow back. This is the worst part about King of Winter. When I did King of Winter, I had a supply of resources. Because it's eternally winter. 1,000 days. Look at that. Look at that. So, campfire. We'll get cold. Or our torch. We'll get cold right away. Let's do this. Don't waste that torch. Thermal stone. You stay here. Well, that didn't last very long. Now did it. Oh goodness me, let's burn down a real tree. So you can see why this is super, super difficult, because we have nothing. There's bunnies over here. Like I said, I might die this time. This is awful. King of Winter is terrible. There's bunnies over there. We can take that and turn them into rabbit earmuffs. That is not a bad idea. It requires traps. How am I cold already? Well, what we'll do is get a campfire going. If I could get a fire pit going, that'd be better, but you obviously require stone, and we don't have that yet. So, let's keep the thermal stone here. You stay warm. I will do my best to push out away from that campfire and gather things, which isn't going to last very long. This is going to be impossible. Oh my goodness, stop it! I'm right here! Right here, game! Terrible. Terrible. Get a good log supply going. You'll need it. So the bunnies, we will want rabbit earmuffs, chest piece, really I'm going to probably rely on a hat. If I get a beefalo hat, that'd be huge. I could get a tam o'shanter because it's eternally winter, the mac tusks and such, they are active. I still have to worry about food, which is berries, everything's limited. Everything is limited. Finding beefalo is clutch because you can use their fuel, their fur is fuel. So let's just gather what I can. As fast as I freaking can. I hate King of Winter. Starting off on it, this is the worst. We don't want to stay here long. If you start off on a world that isn't permawinter, you can just push to the next, in all seriousness. I just need to get enough to get me going to let me explore, because this thermal stone doesn't cut it at all. I need a stack of logs. Let's keep going. I have another axe, but I need to find rocks so I can make more. Is that a... There's a pink block there. That's weird. For some reason, I thought that would have been a wormhole. So burning Mother Nature is your friend to stay warm. Burning tufts, twigs after you've harvested them, because they're useless. Once gone, they're done. They're pointless. So just use them as fuel sources. Even making a shovel and then digging them and then burning them. They last longer that way. Thermal stone's cold. So I will probably do that. Okay, burn you. We go back to that campfire, but we're a little bit far away. Let's get toasty. There should still be hound attacks and such. Get really toasty, please. Come on. Keep going. Get as much of this flint as I can, because it's going to have to hold me over until I can find things to mine. Can't exactly make gold tools yet. You have to prototype this stuff. I don't look forward to this. I'm telling you now, I have zero faith in success on this one. At all. I would not be opposed to making a shovel to burn this stuff in a campfire. Once I get a fire pit and I have a little base that I can rely on, that'd be nice. Grass, just keep grass going. Picking up some of these berries would be a great idea, because we won't be returning to them. I will keep my sanity up with flowers. And how are we cold? The thermal stone was still warm. It's because we have no warm clothing at all. None, nada, nothing nearby, so we're moving away. Blue mushrooms are good sanity. Could take that and just burn the little rinky-dink trees, basically. Bye bye little rinky-dink trees, I'll miss you. I could just sit next to a campfire, but what does that do other than just waste time? you're just waiting for the inevitable if you think about it. So keep moving. The nice thing is, I guess it's a nice thing, is if I find green caps and I get my sanity up using green caps. As Weber, I don't have that much sanity I need to lose before I can go through the portal. So think of it that way. If we could get some spiders, we could get some silk, we could get a top hat, we could get meat, we could get food, we could get healing. I need to find spider bros. It's basically what this is. Killing these dudes would be great for the food, but super risky. Just keeping warm here. And it wouldn't be a bad idea to put a campfire down, just to stay warm throughout the night. Let's do that. And I will want another one pre-crafted, so of course that's just like grass and such. And just keep moving. I've got a hefty supply, or I've got a respectable amount. Hey, I forgot I spawned spider eggs. I can use that to my advantage. But I've got a respectable amount of grass and twigs right now. Just more the merrier. I have to prototype a shovel, so you could dig those up and then burn them. And they're worth more. And you want your nightlight? Well, we'll have to wait until we get some flowers, buddy. So, or not flowers. What am I saying? Oh, man. I don't look forward to this, man. Telling you that now. I can learn this. Oh, this is a life-giving amulet. He didn't even give me the rabbit earmuff thing. What am I saying? I thought I got rabbit earmuffs. Life-giving amulet could help me if I got a red gem and I died. But if I learn that, it should give me sanity. So I'm going to hold off on it. Add that to the fire. Is that a tier 3? I am losing a good bit of sanity over here. It's not a bad thing that you're losing sanity, because you need to lose it to go through places, so keeping a super high sanity isn't that great. But obviously, it's still a risk. You're constantly juggling sanity states. So guys, unfortunately, it is already time to wrap the episode up. I've got a hefty supply of logs. Rabbit earmuffs would be great. A winter hat would be better, so finding beefalo would be clutch. You need to find all the pieces to the portal and then go to the portal. So we are in a race against time. We are a race against dying. There is a savanna biome over here. How large it is, I don't know. This biome is super fruitful with resources, and I should take my time to explore it to its fullest. I mean, if I can hoard these things, because once I leave the area, I'm likely not coming back. Nothing's going to spawn anymore because it's winter forever. So gathering what I can and then going, good idea. Get like stacks of things and then move on. But, yep. Wrapping it up here. Episode 217, Adventure Mode. Oh my god. I'm telling you, we're probably going to die. King of Winter is difficult. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.